Hey everyone, and welcome back to the channel. Today we're diving into three incredibly powerful functions in Google Sheets that will supercharge your data analysis and decision making. I'm talking about the if, ifs, and if error functions. Whether you're a beginner or looking to refine your spreadsheet skills, this video is for you. Let's get started. If you want to practice with me, I'll put a link to this file down below in the description. First up is the if function. This is your go-to for making a single decision based on a single condition. Think of it like this. If something is true, then do this. Otherwise, do that. Let's start in cell C2 with our if function. First of all, I'm just going to put the equal sign to bring up the functions and start typing in if. Here it is right here. So once I select this, and if you have the question mark here, it's going to break down what the if function is. Let me quickly explain this. We have our logical expression. So this is your condition. Its statement can either be true or false. So for example, A1 could be greater than 10, or B2 could say the word complete. Then we have value if true. What do you want Google Sheets to display if your condition is true? Then we'll put another comma in, and what happens if it's false? So what do you want Google Sheets to display if the condition is false? So let's test this out on this sheet. We're going to take a look at the score here, and if it's greater than 60, we want it to say passed. If not, say failed. So first of all, my condition. So I'm going to click on B2 here, and what I'm going to do is just put greater than equal to 60, just like that. So I'm going to place my comma, and then it moves to the first condition. So what do I want it to say if the value is true? Well, I want it to say passed. So make sure you put it into quotation marks, and I'm going to type passed, just like that. Put another comma in, and it's going to move to the next one. And what do I want to say? Well, how about I'll say this. I'll be nice about it. Needs more work. Just like that. I can close my bracket and then hit enter. So right away, it's auto-filling. I could just copy this down. I'm going to just check it like this. So this one's below 60, needs more work. This is above 60, we get passed. That's how simple it is to use the if function. But what if you have multiple conditions and multiple outcomes? That's where the ifs function shines. Ifs allows you to test multiple conditions in a single formula. Let's go to D2 to try out our ifs function, and I'll give you a little explanation. So with our equal sign, we'll type in ifs. Now you'll notice that you have a condition one and a value one, and then it goes to condition two, and then value two, and then so on and so on. All of these are in pairs. Google Sheets checks each condition in order. As soon as it finds the condition that is true, it returns that corresponding value and stops. So let's test it out on our scores here. Again, we're going to look at B2. And the first condition will be saying, let's say if it's greater than or equal to 90. What do I want to have happen? Well, I want them to get an A in this. So I put my comma, and then I'm going to put in quotation marks A. So if it finds that to be true, it will deliver that A. We go ahead and put another comma in. What's going to be the next one? Well, in this case, again, I'm going to want it to be on B2. And this time I'm going to have a different mark. It's going to be greater than equal to, in this case, 80. And this is going to want, I want this to be a B. So we put a comma in, and then we're going to go and put our quotation marks in and put B. Comma again, and let's add two more conditions real quickly. So here you can see what I finished with. C is going to be the 70 and over. 60 is the D. And notice at the end I have true for F. The true at the end, this acts as a catch-all. So if none of the previous conditions are met, true will always evaluate as true, assigning an F to any score below a 60. And remember, order matters. Google Sheets stops at the first true condition, so check for the highest scores first. Let's go ahead and hit enter, and there we have it. It went through each of these. I'll just click the suggested edit, and provided a individual score for each of the marks here. So that's a jump up from using the if to the ifs with what you can do with it. Finally, let's talk about the if error function. No matter how good you are with formulas, sometimes errors happen. Division by zero, looking up values that don't exist, or incorrect data types all lead to that unsightly error message like this one, or this one, or that one. If error allows you to gracefully handle these errors. Let me show an example without using if error first. So with a simple formula like this, we put our equals in and we'll say 85 here, this cell B2 divided by F2. So if I hit enter, this looks fine. If I copy this down, notice we have one of these errors right here. So it can't be divided by zero. And that's what I mentioned. Here was the zero that I have. I'm going to go ahead and just clean this up and we'll use the if error. So this time, all I have to do is start typing if error. And you can see it's a pretty simple formula. I'm going to go and click on my 85 again. And it's going to be just the normal division and put my comma in. And what do I want to have happen here? Do I want it to say NA or blank? So if I was going to just put in brackets and I'll do it like this, NA, and I'll put my other quotation mark and finish it off. Notice it doesn't look like anything happened there, but as I copy it down, now it says NA. So you can also, if I go back and double click in it, if you just want it blanks, if I just remove this now, I can go ahead and copy it down again. And this time I just get a blank in that spot. So that's a great way to handle those messy errors when they pop up, making your sheet much more professional and readable. Practice these and you'll be amazed at how much more dynamic and user-friendly your spreadsheets become. If you found this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe for more Google Sheet tutorials, and let me know in the comments which below function that you find the most useful. Thanks for watching this time, and I'll see you next week with more tech tips and tutorials.